তাহলে তোমাদের জন্য এটা হবে। সো ক্যালকুলেশনস, মোস্ট ক্যালকুলেশনস, সো দিস ইজ হোয়াট উই আর লার্নিং। সো ফার্স্ট ইউ নিড টু আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড রিলেটিভ অ্যাটমিক ম্যাস। রিলেটিভ অ্যাটমিক ম্যাস উই কল দ্যাট RAM। সো ইন আ পিরিয়ডিক টেবল দেয়ার আর লাইক মেনি এলিমেন্টস অ্যান্ড এভরি এলিমেন্টস in a periodic table have a mass number, which is the number at the top of that element, and we have an atomic number. So this is the mass number and this is the atomic number. Now we already know, this, but now what is that mass number represents? For example, if you look at oxygen, it has 16 and 8. So the mass number of oxygen is 16 and the atomic number is 8. So that value 16, or for example nitrogen, you have 14 and 7. So what does this value explain? Or iron, 56, 26. So these are like the examples of the elements that you see in the periodic table. So this mass, what is this? Does 14 means the mass of nitrogen is 14 kilogram or some other unit, 14 tons? Do you know, do you have any idea what does that 14 actually means? What does a mass number actually mean? The number of protons and neutrons. You're right, actually. The mass number shows the number of protons and neutrons. But in reality, when you talk about the mass of an atom, so this mass is called the relative atomic mass. This is your RAM. So this is your RAM. So why it has to be a relative atomic mass? Why it's not just a simple mass? Actually, so this mass is like, so 1 mole of nitrogen. So this mass number means this, that 1 mole of nitrogen is 14 gram. Similarly, for oxygen, 1 mole of oxygen is 16 gram. And for iron, so 1 mole of iron is 56 gram. So this mass number, can you understand that this mass number is actually showing the mass in grams for every mole of that element? If it's nitrogen, 1 mole of nitrogen will be 14 gram. If it's oxygen, 1 mole of oxygen is 16 gram. And if it's iron, 1 mole of iron is 56 gram. Now, why it is relative? Atomic mass is fine. It's RAM. So in case of RAM, R stands for relative. That is because to calculate the mass, when you say about 1 mole, so 1 mole actually means a number. Mole means a number. Mole, 1 mole is actually a number, which is a number. And that number is Avogadro's constant, 6.02 into 10 to the power 23. So when you say 1 mole of nitrogen is 14 gram, so that means 6.02 into 10 to the power 23 atoms of nitrogen. If you take the mass of this much atoms of nitrogen all together, so then the mass will be 14 grams. If there are like 6.02 into 10 to the power 23 nitrogen. Do you understand? For now, what we are doing is just we are trying to understand relative atomic mass. A relative atomic mass bolte gele jokhon moles er kotha ta chole ashe. So like mole, 1 mole, mole mane ta ki? It's like a number. Suppose like kilo, bole na 5K mane 5,000. So K means 1,000. So kilo is stands for 1,000. Mega stands for million. So it's like that, mole stands for a number and that number is this much. 6.02 into 10 to the power 23. So if you say that you have one mole of, suppose like in your bank, if you have one mole money or one mole taka, so then you are very, very rich. So that's a lot of money. So like a mole is simply a number. So now when you talk about relative atomic mass, you mean the mass of one mole of any atom. One mole of any atom. So relative atomic mass, so this is my definition. So the mass of one mole of an atom in grams. The mass of one mole of atom in grams is called the relative atomic mass. Now, interestingly, so I was explaining this. So if you have to measure the mass of nitrogen, you need to put exactly this much amount of nitrogen on a ball. So you cannot always calculate that. So what we know for sure is this one. One element, the mass of one element is exactly same. So that like mass of one mole of carbon is 12 gram. So the mass of one mole of carbon is 12 gram because carbon normally in the periodic table has a mass number 12 and atomic number 6. So we already know that one mole of carbon is exactly 12 gram. But why is this so important? Because all other elements mass is relative to this. I mean, it is always compared with the carbon. For example, if you have one element which is two times, suppose if you now you have a scale and you put one element on this side and you see that you need two carbon, you don't know this element X, and you need two carbon atoms to balance this. So if two carbon atoms is equals to the mass of that element, so that means when you relate it with the carbon atom, so if this each of these carbon atoms is 12 gram, so this element must be 24 gram. So when we find out this mass, we always relate it with carbon, because in reality we cannot calculate atom by atom. We cannot calculate the exact number of atom that we put it on a ball to measure its mass. So what we would do is we would compare the mass of this one with the carbon, and if we see that this much amount of carbon is required for that, so then you actually know that the mass will be relative to the carbon. So that's why it's called relative atomic mass. For example, when you go to a shop to buy some vegetables, suppose you want to buy some potatoes. So now each of the potato that you see does not have a fixed mass. So what the shopkeeper will do is he will put a 1 kilogram mass. Suppose if you want to buy 1 kilogram of potato, so the shopkeeper will put 1 kilogram mass on one side, and on the other side he will start putting some potatoes. So when the mass of those potatoes equals to the mass of 1 kilogram, then the shopkeeper says that this is 1 kilogram mass. So now those mass of those potatoes are relative to the mass that the shopkeeper put originally on the pan, that iron block. Okay, so oita ki bole relative atomic mass, oita ki bole relative mass. So in reality, when we measure the mass of an atom, we always relate it with carbon. So if it is twice the carbon atom, so it must be 24 gram, something similar to this. So however, the simplest way to understand is this: relative atomic mass means the mass of one mole of atom in grams. This part is the definition of mole. One mole. Now the definitions of mole. So this, each of the definitions of mole will give us a formula. So these definitions are very important for you to understand. So one mole of any particle is equal to the Avogadro's number of particles. So if it's one mole, so it's equal to the Avogadro's number of particles. So that means if it's two mole, so that means it will be twice the Avogadro's number. So this is what we get from this formula. So this is the first definition. So number of moles should be equal to number of particles so number of moles amra ektu onno bhabe dekhi so number of particles should be equal to number Avogadro's number the number of moles should be number of particles should be equals to Avogadro's number into the number of moles because one mole of any particles is equals to the Avogadro's number of particles so when you multiply the number of moles with Avogadro's number you always get the number of particles so therefore we can say that number of moles n should be equals to number of particles n number of particles over Avogadro's number AR so n is equals to n by AR so that is the first formula so one mole of any particle is equals to the Avogadro's number of particles so that means the number of particles should be equals to Avogadro's number into the number of moles and so number of moles should be equals to number of particles n divided by the Avogadro's number okay one mole of any element of anything one mole of any element or compound has a mass So one mole of any element or compound has a mass of its relative molar mass in gram as it. So one mole of any element or compound has a mass as its relative molar mass in grams. So that means relative molar mass ta mane ki. Relative molar mass is simple like this. Suppose relative molar mass can we say it MR is equals to RAM or RFM by the way we have just studied RAM before so RFM mane ki do you all know that relative formula mass so relative formula mass hocche ki you add up the mass of a compound for example RFM of carbon dioxide should be equals to 12 plus 16 into 2 44 so rfm hocche ki relative formula mass so rfm othoba rm duita ki bole molar mass okay so now either it can be rfm or it can be rm they both mean the same thing they both means the mr so now let's get back to our definition of moles So one mole of any element or compound has a mass as its relative molar mass in gram. So that means the number of moles is equals to mass over MR. So mass over MR. So if it has a relative molar mass in grams, so now if you multiply the number of moles into molar mass, you should always get the mass of that element. Suppose if there are 1 mole of nitrogen, so if it's 1 mole of nitrogen, it's 14 gram. So if it's 2 moles, it should be 20 gram, 8 gram. So that means what you would do is, if it's 2 moles, the nitrogen has an MR of 14. So if it has 2 moles, so 2 into 14 would be 28 gram. So that is the second formula of moles. The first formula is N is equals to N by AR. N is number of particles. Capital N stands for the number of particles. And the second formula is number of moles is equals to mass by molar mass. This should be small n. We use small n to represent moles. Clear? 1 mole of any gas at RTP. RTP mane ki? Room temperature and pressure, right? Yeah. 1 mole of any gas at room temperature and pressure would always be is equal to has a volume (24 dm³) or 24,000 cm³. So 1 mole of any gas at room temperature and pressure has a volume of 24 dm³ or 24,000 cm³. And that's fixed for any sort of gas. Let it be oxygen, carbon dioxide, chlorine, fluorine, whatever the type of gas it is. Any gas will have 24 dm³. So 1 mole, again, 1 mole stands for, according to our first definition, 1 mole stands for a number of particles. So now, if there are Avogadro's number of particles in a gas, and that number of particles will add up to be 24 dm³ or 24,000 cm³. Anyway, so this is called MV, molar volume. So molar volume MV, is a value that 24 dm³ or 24,000 cm³, this is called MV or the molar volume. So that means number of moles N should be equals to volume divided by molar volume. So if you know the number of moles, suppose 2 moles of carbon dioxide would be 24 into 2, 48 dm³. So if you multiply just MV in the number of moles, you always find the volume. So that's the third formula of moles. So when you multiply moles with molar volume with the number of moles, you find the volume. So N is equals to V by MV. So this, there are four formulas for moles. So this is the third one. So the number of moles is equals to volume over molar volume. And molar volume is 24 dm³ or 24,000 cm³. Okay? And the last formula for moles is this one. For liquid, volume can be measured in dm³ or cm³, etc. Or it can be meter cube, liter. It is always that. Concentration of a liquid would be equals to the number of particles per volume. So number of particles per volume is the concentration of any liquid. So when you want to measure the concentration, you should find out the number of particles per volume. So if it's like the number of particles are measured in moles, so we can say it's moles per dm cube. Number of particles, so it can be moles per cm cube or moles per cm cube. So either it's moles per dm cube or it's moles per cm cube. Both are same. That is how you measure concentration. And the volume is always measured in dm cube or cm cube. So that means number of moles n should be equals to volume V into concentration. See. So what you can see from here, that if it's moles per dm cube is the concentration, and if the volume is measured in dm cube, if you multiply these two, volume and concentration, you get the number of moles. So the number of moles n should be equals to V into C. So that is the fourth equation of moles. So there are these four equation of moles that you need to know. Okay. So